Good morning. Delight to be with you. Before I make my announcements, Rachel would like to just take a few seconds and...
You gave me 30 seconds. I'm giving a call.
That's 10.
This is regarding the normal offering envelopes, which we give as members of the church. They will be available next Sunday. However, in an attempt to reduce our operating expenses, our home purpose costs, we would like to order, we ordered fewer, and therefore, there is a change. I'm warning, it will mean your number will change, but consider that inconvenience as your contribution to our budget. What I would like to know is, those of you who are giving through PushPay or other on the online system, we would prefer you not to have an envelope. You will still have an envelope number, so that we will, for record keeping, it just will not be one of the numbered boxes of envelopes. So if you do not fall in that category, but you also would like to just give periodically by check and not need a box, let me know that so that we can use that box number for someone else. Does that make sense? If you have questions, see me after church. I will be in the fellowship hall to take down any names who would like to not use a boxed envelope for their offering.
No, thank you. A few things to highlight. First, as I think about it, see so many of you here in church today. Christmas Eve service is in, 10 days? 11 days, I guess? 11 days. Our 6 o'clock service that night. We'll probably have ushers helping people come in. If you can come in as a large family group and sit together, that would be greatly appreciated. We'll try and do the best we can to accommodate everybody. We'll have chairs set up in the back if we overflow. Looking forward to that celebration. Church looks awesome. The poinsettias are beautiful. So I'm looking forward to our Christmas Eve service. With that, check your mailboxes. Those of you that have children in our church, there's a little gift in there from the church. Today is our Sunday school program. They went to great lengths to make this happen. Great lengths to make it happen. They videoed it. They put it all together. So that'll be our service this morning. As I say that, if you participated in the Sunday school program, make sure you see Tyler and Julie after church in the back. They have something special for you. Christmas cards are still for sale in the back. The youth, someone from the youth will be back there to do that. Church council tomorrow night at 7 o'clock, not at 8, at 7. And we're just asking that one person from each board show up due to COVID restrictions. We will still meet at 7 o'clock tomorrow night. And then at the end of the service, as part of the Sunday school program, the kids put together some Christmas greetings. So after the last hymn, you can stay seated for a few moments and watch those and enjoy those as well. I think that's all, I hope. A delight to be with you today as we get closer to Christmas. Our first hymn this morning is O Come All Ye Faithful, 379. Blessings to you this day. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
What child is this? A babe is born.
An infant in a stall.
Who can this Son of promise be?
We marvel at the mystery.
We continue with angels we have heard of.
Thank you. sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God to the city of Galilee, the name of Nazareth, to the virgin pledged to the man whose name was Joseph of the house of David, and the virgin's name was Mary.
The angel went to her and said, "Greetings, you are highly favored. The Lord is with you." Mary was greatly troubled at his words.
And the angel said unto her, "Fear not, Mary, for thou hast found favor with the Lord. And behold, thou shalt conceive in thy womb and bring forth a son, and shalt call his name Jesus.
He shall be great, and shall be called the Son of the Highest. And the Lord God shall give unto him the throne of his father David. And he shall reign over the house of Jacob, and for his kingdom it shall have no end."
"How will this be?" Mary asked the angel, "since I am a virgin." The angel answered, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the Holy One to be born will be called the Son of God."
Even Elizabeth, your relative, is going to have a child in her old age, and she who is said to be barren is in her sixth month, for nothing is impossible with God.
"I am the Lord's servant," Mary answered. "May it be to me as you have said." Then the angel left her.
Thank you. God's child?
A baby boy from Mary Miles.
This son will be a special king.
So shout and let your praises ring.
Shepherds abiding in the fields, keeping watch over their flocks by night.
And the glow of the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were afraid.
And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which should be for all people.
For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. This shall be a sign unto you, ye shall find a babe wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger.
And suddenly there with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill towards men.
And it came to pass, as the angels were gone away from them into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, Let us now go to Bethlehem and see this thing which is come to pass, which the Lord hath made known to us.
The angels filled the night time air.
To see and
Jesus has the angel said, and it's so sweet. They laid his head.
Why did he come to earth to dwell? A gift of love, great news to tell.
He came to give his very life to free us from our sinful strife.
When they came into the house, they saw the young child with Mary, his mother, and fell down and worshipped him.
When they had opened their treasures, they presented unto him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
And having been warned in a dream not to go back to Herod, they returned to their country by another route.
Oh, who is this? The King of the World, a gift from God from heaven above.
His Majesty came down to earth, a holy child of lowly birth. Now Jesus reigns above. Below, within our hearts, wherever we go, all nations bow and come adore, our Savior's rules forevermore.
Amen.
Let us stand together as we confess our faith using the words of the Apostles' Creed. What child is this?
A babe is born.
And given to me a soul for Lord.
Who can this son of promise be?
We marvel at the mystery.
What child is this? He came as king.
The nation shouts with his praises ring.
What child is this? He came to die.
Forgiven we can live on high.
What child is this? He came in love. Child is this, O go and tell.
Christ Jesus is Emmanuel.
Now the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you his peace. Amen. You may be seated for our final hymn, Joy to the World, 387.
Merry Christmas!
Merry Christmas!
Hey everyone, hope you enjoyed the Christmas program today. A big thank you to Jeff Zumloff and Pastor King for helping us put these videos together. And a big thank you to the parents also. We couldn't have done it without you.
We wish you a blessed Christmas season. From our home to yours,
Merry Christmas!